Welcome. Today we want to talk about divine right boundaries. So when I peruse the internet, there's always things that come up, right? And today I was wondering what we were going to talk about, and I had an interaction or witnessed really an interaction on Facebook around boundaries. And I thought this is something that I think we really, really need to talk about, whether you're male or female or neither, makes no difference. We don't care whether you're a human being, okay? You need to be able to set boundaries with other people. And when I say boundaries, that really does entail a lot of things. So today we're going to look at it from an energetic perspective and from kind of like this 3D world perspective where we interact on a daily basis. So I'm going to get a little bit earthy today and talk about it from that place because there's a whole bunch of energy stuff that surrounds boundaries around empowerment, self-love, respect, honor, self-honor, self-value that we really can't cover in just this really short live today. So we're going to come down from the ethers, down from the higher realms, and we're going to talk a little bit about how to interact really on Earth with other people.
So, okay.
The topic that came up was there is a young woman, and she goes to school and she's in a class with another person, and he's insulting, and she doesn't really know him. They're not friends. And he criticizes her and makes racial comments, makes comments about her background or upbringing, those types of things. And I think, to some degree, maybe makes her feel unsafe or inadequate. I don't know. I'm projecting that. But the idea behind that was really an interesting thread because there was just a lot of people who gave the same advice, which was ignore them, ignore them, ignore them. And when you are in a situation in the real world, right, where you feel threatened, where you feel as if you're being treated inappropriately, okay, you can ignore it and move on. But what happens is that energy has already hit you. We call that, it could be like energetically, it could be a psychic attack. And that means that somebody else's energy is in your field. And what happens is you want to ignore it. That's great. But your energy is not ignoring it. Because if you're festering about it and you're thinking about it and you're replaying it in your head and it's going over and over and over again, then you're not ignoring it. You're just re-traumatizing yourself the entire time, every time you think of it. When you post it on Facebook to get other people's feedback, you reactivate it. You bring that back into your vibration and you keep experiencing it over and over and over again. And this happens when you don't set boundaries. This happens when you don't turn around to that person and stick up for yourself, to defend yourself, to empower yourself. Okay. And that's kind of like the title that we wrote here, that it's okay to defend yourself and tell people how you feel, right? Because here's my experience, and I don't have these issues with boundaries in kind of like the 3D world, right? Because when those situations happen, I hit a very hard, fast, and quick boundary that is very strong. And it sends a very definitive message of that is not okay. You will not treat me in that matter. And if you do it again, there will be repercussions, okay? And so, when you're dealing with somebody who doesn't really know you that well, who maybe even makes is unaware that they're even insulting you, when you hit them with a hard, fast boundary, okay, the message is very clear. You want to be able to clearly convey and communicate your boundary of what is acceptable and what is not. Okay. And what happens is if you're someone who is not really good at setting boundaries, or you're going to do the whole ignore me thing, what is going to happen is if you don't set that hard and fast boundary, is that it's going to repeat itself because now there's no repercussion. So I just said this to this person and there's no repercussion. She didn't mind. She's just ignoring me. So I'm going to do it again, because now I'm at the place where I'm like, okay, this is an acceptable interaction with this person because she's not setting a hard and fast boundary. When you defend yourself, when you stick up for yourself, you are claiming your power. You are standing in alignment with who you are. You are honoring yourself. You are respecting yourself. And that in and of itself is a vibration of self-love. What you're saying is, I love and respect myself, that I'm not going to accept this behavior which upsets me. Okay, or disturbs me or bothers me. And you're setting that clear boundary. Clear boundaries also create healthy relationships. Why is that? Why would a clear boundary help you create healthy relationships? Because everybody's on the same page, right? It's because everybody knows what the expectation is. Everybody knows how to treat you, right? Everybody kind of knows the rules now. So not everybody knows the rules when they first meet you, and it's kind of like they're pushing little buttons. And there are some people who are there for a particular reason, right? They're there to needle you and make you uncomfortable and make you feel a little awkward. For what reason, right? So energetically, spiritually, that reason would be to help you create stronger boundaries, help you to hold your power a little bit better, help you to clearly communicate, okay? Those people come and go, and you will find that, you know, they come in for that lesson and then they leave, and then things start to shift. So here's the other thing. When you ignore people and you don't address the boundary issue and you move on, and let's just say that that person kind of leaves your arena and you don't see them again, energetically, cosmically, soulfully, whatever you want to call it, that lesson has not been learned, right? You have not learned that lesson of creating that strong divine boundary. So what will happen is the universe will repeat the lesson for you until you get it, right? So that person may have disappeared, but what you'll notice is, oh my gosh, this same person comes into my life and now it's the same thing all over again. You ever have those experiences where you're either dating the same type of boyfriend or girlfriend, and it's just kind of a pattern. It's like, why do I keep attracting the same people? Why do I keep attracting the same clients? Why do I keep attracting the same caliber of coach? You know, why do I keep attracting the same thing? It's because that lesson hasn't been learned yet. That person that you were interacting with the first time around is gone, but the lesson hasn't been activated. And so what happens is you draw in the other person to help you activate that lesson. Divine boundaries are exactly the same thing. And it's a divine lesson of how to honor yourself, respect yourself, value yourself. And that is a form of self-love. So when you're faced with someone who is invading your space, making you feel uncomfortable or unsafe, set a hard and fast boundary. Let them know what the limit is, right? Because if nobody knows what the limit is, they'll drive until they get stopped, okay? And by that time, and in a lot of cases for a lot of clients that I work with, by the time the stop sign hits, it's already too late and the damage has been done. So empower yourself. It's okay to defend yourself. It's okay to turn around and say to somebody, that is inappropriate, and I will not listen to that again. Do not speak to me in that tone. Do not look at me in that fashion, you know, or even, you know, and it doesn't have to necessarily be with anger, right? But just firm, just with strength, right? You want to make sure that you're not acting from a place of anger, right? And reactive, because that is just basically psychically attacking them, but just taking it from that place of strength, of that place of inner empowerment, and setting that boundary of no, you will not speak to me, talk to me, look at me, whatever, in that manner. But you get to choose. You get to choose whether or not to hold your power or give it away. You get to choose if you want to walk around and ignore it and still have it play over and over and over and over and over again. It's entirely choice. We have no judgment. We're just stepping in to say it's okay. it is okay to honor yourself, to respect yourself, and tell somebody else, no, that's not okay.